It's the provenance. It's the place where something comes from, the place where something originates from. It's something where it started from. The point of origin, the point of beginnings, the point of starting, the point of this, the point of that, the point of you. The provenance is where it began and where it starts and where it always has been. So welcome to another episode of Provenance, and today I'm super excited to tell you a little bit about a collaboration that happened a couple of years ago with a company called Polycade. And Polycade and I teamed up and did my own version, a new version, a reversion of Asteroids, a very classic arcade Atari game. And so let me see what happens when I pull up Polycade in my system here. Okay, so we got one product that pulled up. And so this was a limited edition one-of-one Polycade machine that is out there in the world, the console. And you know, there was some nice press about that. So in here you see more of a series of things. So Polycade, we sold it as a digital game, and there was an addition to that game. There was an addition of 1,000. So there's 1,000 digital games out there in the world that people could collect. And within that edition of 1,000, there were a couple of unique special editions. There's also a very fun Polycade screensaver, which we have on the machine here at the studio. So we have a Polycade console at the studio, but I think it's just best to go over there and show you and maybe play a game of Asteroids. But I wanted just to go into my drive here. So I'm in my Google Drive because I wanted to just show you some of the assets that were used to create the game before we go see it. So these were some of the original drawings that I did when thinking about the concept of the game. So you have little player icons, potential UFO icons, these were potential asteroids, and then other elements. So it's kind of nice to see what finally was used in all of this. And all the elements I drew on my iPad and had different colors and variations of that. So yeah, let's just go play that, and I kind of will show you around the game and tell you a little bit about the concept of it. So we have the Polycade screensaver here, and I love this piece, and I collaborated with a good friend of mine, Ben Sheppy, who's all the way in London, to kind of create this and bring this to life. And we've worked on a ton of different projects for over the last 20 years. But this idea is about kind of orbit and space, and the drawings themselves become planetary moments, and they're moving from the bottom of the screen all the way up. And so I had the Polycade console in the studio for a long time, and every time I looked at it and I saw a different type of screensaver, I was like, I want to have my own screensaver on there. And so we worked on this project, and if you have a Polycade console, you should be able to find this and use this screensaver yourself. So let's just get a closer look. And you see we've got a little copyright line here in the corner, but then we have, you know, over here just these really fun elements that are kind of transitioning and moving over time. So this might be one of my favorite pieces in the studio at the moment, perhaps also one of the newest pieces, but I just really enjoy looking at it and seeing it from afar. So within here, the whole system, you can play a bunch of old games, you know, columns and probably games that you played as a kid or your parents played as a kid. And this makes me really happy because it's Asteroids by Chantel Martin. And I was a big Atari fan as a kid and also a big Asteroids fan as a kid. So I've spent many, many hours playing this game as a kid, but now I get to play my own version. So let's go in here. So it brings you in here to this main page, and then we press start. Let me tell you a little bit about what's going on here before we start playing. So these are some of the icons that I showed you earlier that made it to the game. So the asteroids that I have in this game are in the form of faces. And these faces in this game represent different types of egos. And so when I press play, you're going to see the user player icon appear, which is half of a sun. So the kind of the metaphor is that you are a ray of sunlight, you're half of a sun. But when you press move, which is the red button on here, you become your full self. So there's a little bit kind of a story there about like you don't really become your full self until you move. And when you move through life, it's important to shoot these egos that kind of come at you. And then there's this kind of giant eye, which is the UFO for myself in this game. And the eye is keeping an eventful and a constant watch on you. And if you're not being your true self, that eye will just shoot you out of existence. My friend Jan beat my high score, so this is not my high score, which I've been trying to beat now for over a year and I haven't got there yet, but maybe we'll get there today. So also, just lastly, you can see here, we've got a little bit of a title, 2022 Atari Inc. plus Chantel Martin. So it's a little copyright line there, but let's play. So as you can see, I'm just shooting these guys, shooting all the egos. And as you shoot them, they become smaller until you finally evaporate them. There's the eye. See, the eye got me. Okay, we should just play the whole, we should just have people watch me play this the whole way through. That's what you young kids do today. You watch people playing games, but I wonder how interesting these are to watch though. Ah, game over.